So the image is going to look like this. And now I'm going to define the ASCII characters that can appear inside our art. Then these are the characters. This is the original image and this is the generated ASCII art with the colors retained. All right, so first I'm going to start off with declaring the image path that we have. And since this is Google Colab, I already had it dragged in. So the image is going to look like this. Now we're going to convert this into ASCII and also retain the colors. First, the image path is going to be, since I've already dragged it in, I'm just going to type in logo.jpg. Make sure to put that inside a string, jpg, like that. And then I'm also going to set the width of our generated ASCII art. This is going to, actually, let's just type this in. And I'm going to have this to be by default as 100 pixels. You can have this to be whatever number you want, and accordingly, it will calculate the height itself with the function that we're going to declare. So the function that we're going to use is going to call this to be, let's just close this, image to ASCII art, like that, which will take in the image path, and then it's also going to take in the output width, which again, by default, I'm just going to set this to be 100. So before running this code cell, we will write our function above. It's going to define this, define image, and then it's going to type in pass on this code cell, and now I'm going to import the library that we're going to use in this video, which will be PIL, and we're going to import the image, import image, like that, on this code cell. Now we can start using this image. So our main image is going to be image.open, and we have to pass in the image part that we got, like that. Now this is going to get stored onto the variable. By using this image.open function, we get the image itself, and we store that onto img. Now what I'm going to do is set the aspect ratio first. Aspect ratio will be image.height. It's going to have a specific height, and then I'm also going to divide that by image.width. Now this will give us the aspect ratio, and we can multiply that with the output width so that we can get the output height as well. So what I'm going to do is output height will be aspect ratio into output width, like that. And let's just make sure to put this inside integer 90, like that. Now we get the output height and we already have the output width as well. So our output ratio for the art itself is generated. Now we can just get to the inside part that is actually generating the art. So first I'm going to resize the given image to our required dimensions. So image.resize, and then put this inside a tuple. We're going to start with output width, comma the output height, like that. And now I'm going to define the ASCII characters that can appear inside our art. I'm just going to call this to be ASCII cast, and this will be, I'm just going to put this inside the string format. Then these are the characters. After this, I'm also going to declare another variable, which will be our final ASCII image. This will contain our art. So these are the initial parameters that we will need. We have set up the aspect ratio according to our output width and the output height. And then we've also declared the ASCII characters that will be generated. And then we have created a blank string in which our actual art is going to be available. So what I'm going to do is start a loop for y in range of output height. I'm going to loop over the output height pixel by pixel. And I'm also going to do the same thing for output width as well. I'm just going to call this to be x in range of output width, like that. And now we can get the RGB values of specific pixels by typing in R, G, B. These are the three variables which will store the red, green, and the blue color respectively. And I'm just going to type in image.getPixel, and then you want to pass in the X value, the Y value. So this is going to return the pixel value of that specific point in terms of the X axis and the Y axis, which we are looping through over the height and the width. So we get the RGB values of that specific pixel. And I'm also now going to declare the intensity, that is the brightness level of that specific pixel, which will be the average of RGB, divide this by 3. Now this is going to give us a grayscale image, which is just going to be a number between 0 and 255, where 0 means black and 255 means white. Anywhere between that will give us the brightness of the exact pixel. Now what I'm going to do is map the intensity to the specific ASCII character that we're going to use. So what I will do is our ASCII character for this specific loop where we get pixel components as RGB and we have also got the intensity. For this specific pixel, we're going to get the list that we created as ASCII cast. And then inside this, this is going to be kind of tricky. What you have to do is type in intensity divided by 255. So this is going to give us a number between 0 and 1, indicating the brightness of that specific pixel. And according to that specific brightness, we want to select an ASCII character from our list. So let's say if this is going to give us a number of, let's say, 0.5. And for 0.5, let's say I'm going to use the plus symbol. So wherever there's 0.5 intensity in the actual image itself, it's going to be replaced by this plus in our actual ASCII art image. So first, what I've done here is just divide this by 255. And I'm also going to multiply this with our length of the ASCII characters that we created. ASCII cast, just type minus 1. So this is going to give us the entire length of the ASCII character string that we created. And we're multiplying that with the specific intensity for that pixel. So this is overall going to give us an index, which we're going to get from the ASCII characters itself. So let me just type in int. So again, if you just substitute some of the values, you're going to actually understand what's happening here. Let's again say that the example that we took over here, the intensity value will be 0.5. And we're multiplying that with our ASCII character length, which is going to be 10. When you multiply 0.5 into 10, it's going to give you 5. And if this index is 5, then ASCII characters index of 5, which will return plus. I hope that made sense. But then if you rewind this part once again, you're going to understand this better. Now, all that I'm going to do is type in ASCII image that we created plus equal to this ASCII character. So for each pixel, we're going to have an ASCII character, and I'm just appending that to the ASCII image. So finally, we're going to get a string that kind of looks like the image itself in the ASCII format. Then outside of the output width for loop, we want to type in ASCII as new line. ASCII image will be slash n, put this inside string. Again, since we're going to the next line by iterating over the height, we're just setting ASCII image to new line. Actually, put in plus equals it, like that. Now, if you just print this, you're going to get an ASCII art where the text color will be white. So let's just try that first and then get to retaining the colors on the text itself. So let me just run this. Okay, now I'm going to type on this. Oops, we forgot to print this. Let me just go over here, print the final ASCII image. And run this once again. And run this. There you go. Actually, let me just zoom out a bit. So right, as we see, this is our original image, and this is the ASCII art with the text being just in white color. Now we can just retain the actual colors and then put that inside of our text. Let's show you how. Now for doing this, I'm going to use ANSI codes. Again, if you don't know what that means, I will just leave a link in the description box below where you can see what ANSI is. But then it's just basically string formatting with colors. Instead of explicitly adding in the ASCII character directly, what I'm going to do is retain the color for this specific pixel ASCII character and then add that to ASCII image. So here, let's just define a formatted string. And then first, let me just close this. And since this is a formatted string, whenever you're going to refer to a variable, you have to put this. And now when you type an ASCII character, actually put this, it's going to refer to the actual variable itself. So what I'm going to do now is first type in backslash 033. This is just an escape character, just indicating that we're going to start the text formatting. And then you want to put a semicolon. Actually, I want to type this first. So this four characters together indicates that we're going to start text formatting in terms of colors. And we want to type in semicolon 38. Now this 38 number is just saying that we're going to format the text color, that is the foreground color. And I'm also going to type in 2. And this 2, the number 2 will indicate that we're going to give the values in terms of RGB. And we already have our RGB values for that specific pixels. I'm just going to refer to that by using the curly braces. RGB, like that. And I'm going to directly map this to our ASCII character, like that. Also, type 033, open brackets, 0M. Now, this is the escape character to come out of the text editing block. And now this should actually give us the specific color of the image by using the RGB formatting. Again, this indicates the start of inside text formatting, and we want to segregate each of the values by semicolon. And then I've typed in 38 to indicate that I'm going to change the text color. And I've typed in 2 to indicate that I'm going to give the values in RGB. Gave in the values RGB and then mapped that over to the ASCII character, added that to the ASCII image. And now when you run this code cell, and actually type in logo.jp. Gonna get the colors itself. Again, let me just zoom out. Again, as we see over here, we get the colors itself. Let's just first change the output width a little bit. now run this code cell once again. Okay, so here we see that we get the ASCII art along with the colors retained. Let me just show you the original image. This is the original image, and this is the generated ASCII art with the colors retained.